Okay, this is going to be the third and last video about dividing a polynomial by a polynomial using algebraic long division. And I just want to use one more because these things get kind of tricky, and typically the more practice you get with them and the more you see them done, the better off you'll be. So here's the problem. We've got 2x to the third minus 6x minus 6 divided by x minus 2. So I'm dividing by x minus 2, and I'm dividing into 2x to the third minus 6x minus 6. The first thing I see is that when I look at my exponents, I've got a 3, and I've got the 1 here at the negative 6x, but I haven't got a 2. So I've got to remember to fill in a dummy exponent, a blank or zero term. So this is going to be 2x to the third plus 0x squared, because I don't have an x squared, minus 6x minus 6. Okay, so we're going to go through this process over and over again. I take the first term here in my divisor, divide it into the first term that I see here. So x divided into 2x to the third is going to give me 2x squared. So I'll place that over my x squared term. 2x squared times x gives me 2x to the third. These match, so things are good. Then I've got 2x squared minus 2 is going to give me a negative 4x squared. I'm subtracting. So subtracting the 2x to the third minus 2x to the third, these cancel. I've got 0x squared minus negative 4x, minus negative is the same as positive. So I've got 0 plus 4, this will give me 4x squared. Bring down my next term, negative 6x. Divide x into 4x squared, that will give me plus 4x. Multiplying, which is distributing this 4x across the whole divisor. 4x times x is 4x squared. These are the same. 4x times negative 2 is going to be negative 8x. I'm subtracting. The 4x squared and the negative 4x squared cancel. Negative 6x minus negative 8. Minus negative 8 is the same as plus 8. So negative 6 plus 8 is a positive 2. So I've got 2x. Bring down my next term. Minus 6. X divided into the first term here into 2x goes 2 times. Plus 2. 2 times x minus 2. I'll have 2x. 2 times negative 2 is going to give me negative 4. Subtracting, I have negative 6 minus negative 4. Minus negative 4 is plus 4. Negative 6 plus 4 is negative 2. So this is my remainder. And this remainder is going to go up here with the answer. There's the minus sign. And then it's going to be 2 over x minus 2. Okay? So now, let's check this. And you realize when we go to check this, I've got x minus 2, and I want to multiply it by 2x squared plus 4x plus 2. Now, in the previous problems, we multiplied a binomial times a binomial, and you use this foiling method. But here we've got a binomial times a trinomial, and so here's a new kind of multiplication. I want to multiply, where am I? X minus 2 times the answer that I got, 2x squared plus 4x plus 2, and then I want to include my remainder, so I'm going to have a negative 2. Okay, so here's how we do this. We're going to set this up, the multiplication problem, the multiplication part, we're going to set that up just like a regular long multiplication. So here's what I mean. We're going to have 2x squared plus 4x plus 2, and we're multiplying that by x minus 2. And this is multiplying this times this. I don't want to write a multiplication sign because this thing is full of x's already. And then remember, whatever I get, I have to include my negative 2 in the answer. So I'm just going to multiply this negative 2 times everything here. That's going to give me negative 2 times 2 is negative 4. Negative 2 times 4x is negative 8x. Negative 2 times 2x squared will be negative 4x squared. And now I'm multiplying x times everything here. So x times 2 is 2x, that's positive. Notice I line up my x terms. Then I've got x times 4x, that's going to be a positive 4x squared, and x times 2x squared is 2x to the third. And now I'll just add these two polynomials together. So I get 2x to the third. This negative 4x squared and positive 4x squared will cancel. I have a negative 8x plus 2x is negative 6x minus 4. And then I want to remember this negative 2. So I'm going to bring that down and subtract 2 from everything. So simplifying this, I get 2x to the third minus 6x minus 6. And now I want to go back to my original problem and make sure that's the same as the original numerator. So I've got 2x to the third minus 6x minus 6. Okay, so this problem was a little bit harder. The division part follows all the same rules that we dealt with earlier. They were just bigger, it was just a bigger polynomial. And checking it, we used a long multiplication method, which you probably are not going to learn in class, but it might be useful just to study this and see if it makes sense to you. Okay, so that's it. I hope this has helped you. Take care.